स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रिया। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द डिवीजन ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स एंड आल्सो वी विल लर्न सम प्रॉपर्टीज रिलेटेड टू इट। सो लेट्स स्टडी व्हाट इज डिवीजन ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स। डिवीजन ऑफ रैशनल नंबर्स, इफ यू हैव टू रैशनल नंबर्स से पी अपॉन क्यू एंड आर अपॉन एस, देन इफ यू हैव टू डिवाइड बोथ ऑफ देम, दैट इज पी अपॉन क्यू डिवाइडेड बाय आर अपॉन एस, हियर यू हैव टू जस्ट multiply the first rational number with the reciprocal of second rational number, that is p upon q multiplied by reciprocal of r upon s will be s upon r. So multiplying these rational numbers, that is p multiplied by s upon q multiplied by r, that's it. Properties of division of rational numbers, the first property is closure property. So if you have any rational number, say p upon q and r upon s, then the division of both these rational numbers is again a rational number. So division of rational numbers are said to be closed. Now commutative property. Division of rational numbers do not satisfy commutative property. That is, if you have two rational numbers p upon q when divided by r upon s is not equals to r upon s when divided by p upon q. Similarly, division of rational numbers do not follow associative property. That is, if you have three rational numbers, say p upon q, r upon s and u upon v, then p upon q when divided with the division r upon s dividing u upon v is not equals to p upon q divided by r upon s, which is then further divided by u upon v. Now rule of one. So when if you have any rational number, say p upon q, when it is divided by 1, you get the same rational number again. That is, you get identity rational number. Rational number divided by itself. When any rational number is divided by the same rational number again, that is, have p upon q divided by p upon q. That means p upon q is multiplied by its reciprocal, that is q upon p. So this q q goes off and here p p goes off. So the answer is 1. That is, rational number when divided by itself gives 1 as the answer. Now we start with the 7th exercise. The first question is divide 8 upon 15 divided by 2 upon 6. So that is 8 upon 15 divided by 2 upon 6. So that will be equals to 8 upon 15 multiplied by the reciprocal of this number. So 6 upon 2. Now we can reduce this number. So 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8, and here these two numbers will be divisible by 3. So 3 twos are 6 and 3 fives are 15. So we get 4 multiplied by 2 and 5 multiplied by 1. So it will give you 4 twos are 8, 5 ones are 5. This will be your final answer. Now the next question is 0 divided by 4 upon 43. That is 0 divided by 4 upon 43. So 0 multiplied by reciprocal of the second rational number, that is 43 upon 4. And you know 0 when multiplied by any number is 0. So 0 multiplied by this rational number will be 0 only. The second question is simplify and express your answer as a rational number in the standard form. So we have to simplify this rational number and then express it into standard form. The question is 5 upon 12 divided by 3 upon minus 14. So 5 upon 12 will be as it is. Division will be replaced by multiplication sign and reciprocal of the second rational number. So it will be minus 14 upon 3. Now we can reduce this number. 12 and 14 are divisible by 2, so we will reduce by 2. So 2 6 is 12 and 2 7 is 14. So we will get 5 multiplied by minus 7 upon 6 multiplied by 3. So it will be 75 is 35 minus 35 upon 18. This will be your final answer. The third question is, show that A divided by B divided by C is not equal to A divided by B and then divided by C. That is, we have to prove that associative property for the division of this given rational number does not hold. So the question is, A is given as 3 upon 2, B is minus 7 upon 6 and C is 5. We will take LHS first and then we will solve for RHS and then we will prove that both are not equal. LHS equals to A divided by B divided by C. So it will be A is 3 upon 2 divided by B is your minus 7 upon 6 divided by C is 5. 5 means 5 upon 1. So 3 upon 2 divided by, we will solve the bracket first, minus 7 upon 6 multiplied by this reciprocal 1 upon 5. So it will be equals to 3 upon 2 divided by this. Minus 7 multiplied by 1 will be minus 7. 6 5 is 30. So now 3 divided by 2 multiplied by the reciprocal of this number. So it will be minus 30 upon 7. Now we can reduce this term. So 2 1s is 2. 2 15s is 30. Finally you get 3 multiplied by minus 15 upon 1 multiplied by 7. So that will be equals to minus 45 upon 6. This is your LHS. Now we solve for RHS. RHS will be equals to A divided by B, which is then divided by C. Now we substitute the given values. A is 3 upon 2 divided by minus 7 upon 6 divided by 5. So 5, which is equals to, we will solve this bracket first. So it will be 3 divided by 2. Division sign will be replaced by multiplication sign and reciprocal of this rational number. So it will be minus 6 upon 7 divided by 5. Now here again 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6. So you will get here 3 multiplied by minus 3 upon 1 multiplied by 7 divided by 5. So here 3 3s are 9. So minus 9 upon 7 divided by 5. Now we will take the reciprocal of second number. So 5 means 5 upon 1. So it will be minus 9 upon 7 multiplied by 1 upon 5. So it will be minus 9 1s is 9 and 7 5s is 35. So RHS you get minus 9 upon 35 and LHS was minus 45 upon 7. So by comparing you can see LHS is not equal to RHS. Therefore LHS is not equal to RHS. Therefore, you can conclude that associative property does not hold. Fourth question is, the product of two rational numbers is minus 20. So when two rational numbers are multiplied, you get minus 20 as the answer. If one of the numbers is 5 upon 6, find the other number. So let the other number be x. Let the required number B x. One number is this, so 5 upon 6 multiplied by x equals to this answer, minus 20. So for finding x, we will transpose this number to that side and opposite of multiplication is division, so this will be divided there. Therefore x will be equals to minus 20 divided by 5 upon 6. So you will get minus 20 multiplied by its reciprocal 6 upon 5. So 5 1s are 5, 5 4s are 20. So you will get minus 4 multiplied by 6. So therefore, x equals to minus 24. So thus you can conclude that minus 24 when multiplied by this rational number gives minus 20 as the answer. Sixth question is, by what number should minus 12 upon 35 be divided to get 3 upon 7? So by what number we will assume that number to be x? Let the required number be x. By what number should this be divided? So minus 12 upon 35 divided by x gives you 3 upon 7. So 3 upon 7. Therefore, so we will first transpose this x to right hand side. It will give you minus 12 upon 35. Division will go there and get multiplied. So 3 upon 7 multiplied by x. Now we can easily transpose this rational number to left hand side. So therefore minus 12 upon 35 divided by 3 upon 7 equals to x. That is, your x will be equals to minus 12 upon 35. This division will be replaced by multiplication. And then reciprocal of 3 upon 7 is 7 upon 3. Now we can reduce this. 3 ones are 3, 3 fours are 12, and 7 ones are 7, 7 fives are 35. So therefore, x equals to minus 4 multiplied by 1 upon 5 multiplied by 1. That is, your x equals to minus 4 by 5. Thus, you can conclude that minus 4 upon 5 should be divided with minus 12 upon 35 to get 3 upon 7 as the answer. Eighth question is, divide the sum of 8 upon 3 and 12 upon 7 by their difference. So, we have to divide the addition of these two numbers by their subtraction. That is, 8 upon 3 plus, that is sum, 7 upon 12 divided by 8 upon 3 minus 12 upon 7. Okay. So, for addition or subtraction of rational numbers, first we have to equalize the denominator. That we will do here. We will multiply here by 7 and here by 3 in the numerator and denominator. Again here by 7, here by 3. So you will get 7 8 is 56, 7 is 21 plus 12 3 is 36 upon 21 divided by the same number, 56 minus 36 upon 21. So adding these two numbers will give you 6 6 is 12, carry 1, 5 plus 4 is 9 upon 21 divided by 56 minus 36 is 20 divided by 21. Now 92 upon 21, division will be replaced by multiplication sign, and reciprocal of this number is 21 upon 20. 21 goes off and you are left with 92 divided by 20. Both numerator and denominator are divisible by 4. So you will get 4 2's are 8 and then 4 3's are 12 upon 4 5's are 20. That is, 23 upon 5 is the final answer. With this, I finish with your 7th exercise. In the next lecture, I will explain how to represent rational numbers on a number line. Till then, practice this all problems again. Take care. Bye and have a nice day.